By outward appearance, she's the most serene of the planets. A cool blue cosmic gem. But forged by the Big Bang of creation. In that beginning was also born an asteroid aimed for Earth.
Whoa!
That's better. That's the trouble with asteroids. They raise such a racket. And that's not the worst of it. Hello, I'm Leonard Nimoy. Asteroids have been front page lately, especially the so-called Doomsday asteroid, the galactic bullet with our planet's name supposedly written on it. In the new feature film, Armageddon, a space mountain the size of Texas is on a crash course towards Earth.
What hit us?
Small asteroid fragments.
What kind of damage?
Total, sir. It's what we call a global killer. The end of mankind. Doesn't matter where it hits, nothing would survive.
My God. What do we do?
Perhaps it's not if we'll be hit, but when. Tonight, we investigate the possibility of a doomsday asteroid. Will there be any warning?
The first we would know is when we saw the flash of light and felt the ground shake.
Have there been close calls?
The asteroid that I discovered, with only 4 days warning, there would have been no way to stop it.
Can the world fight back?
We have no operational capability to deal with an incoming object at this time.
Mission, the stars.
The asteroid could be heading towards us right now, and we'd have no idea.
Sights set for an asteroid whose target is Earth. I'm not on a sci-fi movie set, nor is that an alien landscape behind me. We're in the high Arizona desert, where a real visitor from outer space once landed. A small asteroid hit right here. The rock was only 150 feet wide, but look at that hole. Amazingly, 1,000 tons of solar debris hit the planet each day and night. Most smaller than grains of sand, but some the magnitude of a Mount Everest. Such an asteroid once thundered towards Earth. During the age of the dinosaurs, firestorms raged across the planet. It was a global killer, incinerating 75% of all life. Doomsday. Not the first, not the last. But from its ashes, a new species would rise.
The flight has cleared his weather command, and there go, and that puts us fully ready to proceed.
Okay, stand by and MMP here.
The course of evolution jolted by a cosmic collision. Without that doomsday, the human race would not exist.
Of all of Florida at this moment, out the window.
How ironic. We, the children of an asteroid, are the first species possessing the power to save ourselves from another Armageddon. I'm in the firing room theater at the Kennedy Space Center Visitor Complex. It was from here at Cape Canaveral where our rendezvous with the stars began 3 decades ago, when man set foot upon a place whose only previous visitors had been asteroids.
Gentlemen, I can well imagine that a foreign planet must be a weird thing to see.
Bear witness to eons of asteroid hits. In fact, an asteroid blasted the moon from Earth as the planet was formed. So the man on the moon is literally a chip off the old block. Old Scarface. But for all the lunar dents, Mother Earth has suffered millions more. Vegetation and water camouflage the wounds. But strip away the makeup, and you'll see the damage left by asteroids. Like the one that hit our Atlantic coast long ago. once a crater, now idyllic Chesapeake Bay near Baltimore. And this is Pittsburgh, as seen in a home video. Suddenly, in the sky, a mini asteroid. Thousands hit the atmosphere daily. Fortunately, most vaporize. But those that don't become meteorites. Like this one, seen all along the East Coast. It finally fell to Earth on Michelle Knapp's car in Westchester, New York.
I was sitting in my house watching TV, and the next thing you know, I heard this loud noise. It sounded like a car accident.
The football-sized alien weighed in at about 27 pounds.
The Homie the Rock was estimated at 4 billion years old, which is about as old as the Earth itself.
Weathersfield, Connecticut is old, too. In fact, the decisive Battle of Yorktown was planned on the fields of Weathersfield by General George Washington himself. But it was just a few years ago when a really ancient traveler dropped in right through the Donahue's roof.
It came through the ceiling of the living room. It bounced from there into the dining room.
And then rolled underneath the dining room table. And we looked up and saw this huge hole. We could see the stars. And we
just looked at each other and asked a very intelligent question. I asked Juan and she asked me, what happened?
What happened also happened a few blocks away. Amazingly, another meteor hit this Weathersfield home 10 years earlier. So what are the chances an asteroid will blast your home? We asked the man who knows the numbers, Dr. David Morrison of NASA's asteroid surveillance team.
You know, a lot of people play the odds at the track, but what about the odds that the Earth will be hit by a comet or asteroid with catastrophic consequences? Chances are about 1 in 5,000 that we will have a global catastrophe from an impact during your lifetime or your children's. Would you get on an airplane if the chances were 1 in 5,000 that it would crash?
There's heavy traffic in space, trillions of orbiting bodies, many in crash courses. In fact, Vehicle Earth has a better chance of a fatal collision in orbit than you do on the highway. Swarms of unidentified asteroids are lurking throughout the solar system.
How many asteroids are there out there that could devastate life on Earth? Probably about 1,000 larger than a mile in diameter.
It would take just one to wipe us out. And one almost did in 1996. It came out of nowhere. Take a peek at a real-life Armageddon. See it?
Asteroids look like hyphens on the films. They're little trails, and all the stars are points.
A little hyphen like that could spell the end of the world. And this one was accidentally discovered by a college student.
It was a shock. It was, you know, jaw-dropping.
The next night, Tim shot it again, fearing the hyphen had grown.
The trails were longer on the films, and it was obvious the object was close because it had sped up a lot.
The giant asteroid was 4 days away.
That's way too short notice. Then it would have been quite messy had it hit.
The space rock was so mammoth, its impact would match the combined nuclear arsenal of the entire world.
So I waited for 12 hours, totally numb.
Most of the public knew nothing about it. On May 20th, 1996, Tim Spar's asteroid slipped past Earth, missing by a whisker, as near as the moon.
Earth had a very close call with doomsday, with almost no warning. Why? Because practically no one is watching. There are more people working in your average McDonald's than astronomers patrolling the heavens.
That's why no one had ever seen an actual asteroid or comet hit a planet in our solar system. Until
March 23rd, 1993. We had all seen comets before, but never anything quite like that.
It was on a crash course with Jupiter. The historic sighting by Dr. Gene Shoemaker, his wife Carolyn, and David Levy, who remembers his friend saying,
I don't believe this. We are actually going to see an impact in my lifetime.
Target Jupiter. That smoke plume is the size of Earth.
I've often imagined what would have happened if Shoemaker Levy 9 had collided with the Earth.
Perhaps an opening salvo, as in these scenes from Armageddon.
The first little guy, half a mile across, would have come barreling through the Earth's atmosphere, destroyed the ozone layer worldwide. If it were a land impact, you'd have the enormous amount of material raining down at ballistic speeds everywhere. No place would be forgiven from this. And those of us who are left to enjoy the scenery after that would be treated to a cloud of dust over the entire Earth, and that, something we call impact winter. It's a good possibility that the one with our name on it, the object that is going to strike the Earth, will be found by someone in his or her backyard using a telescope just like this.
Maybe a backyard astronomer like Carl in the movie Armageddon.
It looks like something's burning up there. Go get my phone book, will you? Get my phone book. Get those names of those guys from NASA.
Excuse me, am I wearing a sign that says Carl Slave?
Go get my phone book!
The question isn't if it's going to happen, the question is when.
The most likely warning is zero. The first we'd know is when we saw the flash of light and felt the ground shake.
In the film, there's a little more warning.
We didn't see this thing coming?
Well, our object collision budget's $1 million. That allows us to track about 3% of the sky.
We have 18 days before it hits Earth.
This may be the front line of our defense against Armageddon. The launch pad at Cape Canaveral, where the space shuttle is poised to blast off to the stars. But what if a killer asteroid were heading this way, threatening Earth? Are we prepared to fight back? The surprising, even shocking answers in a moment.
If you're assuming that if there's an incoming object, somebody's going to get a call and say, don't worry, we'll take care of it. If you're assuming that that somebody's within the government, there's nobody to answer the phone.
At 40,000 miles an hour, just a small chunk from space blasted a mile-wide hole in the desert. Fortunately, that was 50,000 years ago. How often does an asteroid this size hit? Every 50,000 years, give or take a millennium. If this had been Manhattan, it would have wiped out all of New York City. Like these scenes from the movie Armageddon. But how real is this? Take the armadillo, an asteroid hot rod from the movie. Here near Meteor Crater, we got her up to highway speed.
I wanted something that was very cool, very unique. And we finally came up with this vehicle that was put on a Humvee chassis. It's like 22 feet long and 17 feet wide.
A wondrous figment of a filmmaker's imagination.
It was a prop that cost us about $1 million.
Actually inspired by NASA's micro rover, which will land on an asteroid in 2002.
Asteroids have been getting a lot of bad press. What some people don't understand is that there are extraordinary opportunities for mining asteroids in the next century.
Scientific pictures paint the prospect of a gold mine.
The mineral wealth on asteroids between the orbits of Mars and Jupiter is something like $20 billion for every man, woman, and child on the Earth's surface.
We struck oil, baby!
Based on that real NASA plan, the movie makers came up with a way to save the world.
We drill. We bring in the world's best deep core driller.
Who's Harry Stamper?
Hey, I'm Harry Stamper.
Well, they asked him to save the world. They said, you're the only shot we have at going up and trying to stop this asteroid coming in.
Just go up, land on the rock, drill the hole, put the bombs in, take off, detonate.
That's the plan. He says he won't go unless he can take his hand-picked crew, and they're not very good at a lot of other things in life, a lot of social graces, but good oil drillers and good hole drillers.
Armageddon.
Armageddon is about a group of guys who are roughneck oil drillers who all of a sudden are called upon to be put in this absolutely extraordinary situation.
Come and get Papa Bear!
They're very everyday kind of folks. Well, it could easily be you or I or anybody.
The idea of drilling on an asteroid and sending these oil drillers up there is, you know, everybody can relate to it because it's the common man.
The United States government just asked us to save the world.
You know me. Beat me up, Scotty.
The transportation business. That's what I love about sci-fi. Good science fiction takes you on a good ride because it's based on good science facts. Want to know how the military plans to defend the globe in case of an impending collision? Well, take a look at Plan A.
If today we were to discover an asteroid, about all we could do is try and launch a nuclear warhead on currently existing launch technology.
You should know that the president's scientific advisors are suggesting that a nuclear blast could change this asteroid's trajectory.
Would it do any good? Most likely not.
Hitting the rock from the outside won't do the job.
Imagine a firecracker in the palm of your hand. You set it off, what happens? Burn your hand, right? You close your fist around the same firecracker and set it off. Your wife's gonna be opening your ketchup bottles the rest of your life.
Is the sky falling your sci-fi?
The association that many people have with regard to asteroids, it's like the little aliens, the little green aliens. They're not real, we don't have to worry about it. This is very real.
I think authenticity is very important. I think you gotta make, even though this is future fact, I think you gotta make the facts that are real as they can be.
I actually stepped inside the Space Shuttle Columbia. That's one of the most incredible experiences of my life. Having that level of access to NASA was truly impressive.
You guys are real astronauts, huh?
Yeah. You know, I found myself all of a sudden in the neutral buoyancy lab. Okay. Simulating weightlessness, wearing an actual spacesuit. Bruce Willis and I were the only two non-astronauts ever to wear the suit. We were measured meticulously for them. I mean, they take the smallest measurements, like from, you know, here to here, because that's a part of the suit that has to fit just right.
I wanted it very real.
Now, we only have one shot of landing on this rock.
So realistically,
that's precisely when the asteroid passes by the moon.
How do you land on an asteroid? Well, first you have to catch it. Former astronaut and physicist Joe Allen helped figure out a plausible plan.
Keep in mind, the asteroid might be traveling 25,000 miles an hour, much faster than a speeding bullet.
You'll then use lunar gravity.
The filmmakers used quite a clever invention, which is to use another object to swing around as a person might crack the whip and change one's direction that way, using both the gravity of the other object. In the film, it's the moon that's used, and augment that or kick it with additional rockets that you've carried along.
You'll be moving at 22,500 miles per hour, coming around behind the asteroid, where we're hoping that the tail debris will be cleared by the moon's gravity.
It's the physics of Sir Isaac Newton and Johannes Kepler.
The physics may be real, but one locale is wholly imaginary. The landscape of an asteroid.
This place is like Dr. Seuss's worst nightmare.
The roughnecks must fight fury face on. Cosmic hurricanes, quakes, and eruptions.
I don't think this thing likes us.
Anything is possible, because no one has ever seen the surface of an asteroid. Until now. This is a Doppler radar picture of a 3-mile-wide asteroid. Doomsday Big, seen for the first time.
It's almost as if we've sent a spacecraft there. The spacecraft was the Earth, and the instrument was the Goldstone radar telescope.
This space mountain will cross our orbit. But sleep easy, Earth is not a target. We've got our eye on this global killer.
For just a few million dollars a year, we could find out if there's anything headed toward us that's really dangerous during the next century. It probably should be thought of as the most serious environmental hazard that faces humanity.
This is the only natural catastrophe we can avoid.
We don't know any way to stop an earthquake from happening, but if an asteroid were found headed for us, we could deflect it and save the planet.
I think the Apollo era showed us that if we set a goal technologically, we can make incredible advancements.
We're real problem solvers, and I hope you never lose that can-do American attitude, and that's what NASA is.
If I can stand here and tell you that I lived on the moon, that I called the moon my home for 3 days, you tell me what is impossible. Nothing is impossible.
The doomsday asteroid, fact or fiction? There is one out there, a space boulder thousands of times more powerful than the one that caused this damage in the Arizona desert. Armageddon has happened before. It will happen again, unless we have the vision and the heroes to save our planet. So, heads up.